All software is open source if you know assembly. Sometimes said as all software is open source if you're good enough at reverse engineering. This is a joke. And as most jokes are intended to be, it's intended to be humorous and not taken seriously. However, what if we did exactly that? What if I turn the humor part of my brain off and we overanalyze the joke as if it is a true statement, and the level of mental gymnastics you need to go through to make it at least appear true? There's a couple of obvious problems we need to deal with. The first one being the definition of open source. We have the definition that people in the FOSS world use, and then the one that everybody else uses, including non-technical people and technical people alike that maybe just hadn't ever gotten involved in the open source space. In the FOSS world, we use the open source definition as defined by the open source definition from the Open Source Initiative. Now, part of this is the source code being available, literally the first 3 points. But this isn't the only thing required. The license you have can't discriminate against certain groups of people or fields of endeavor, so you can't say that people from America can't use your software, and you can't say your software can't be used in, I don't know, education, for example. The license must not be specific to a product. So if you have a software suite and you take a part of that suite out and make it its own independent thing, the license for that doesn't change. Likewise, if you take a piece of software and then put it into a suite, the terms of the license on that software don't restrict the other software. Now, that's just a high-level look at it. If you've never read through the open source definition, I would highly recommend doing so. Now, we also know that a project doesn't just become open source. Just because you make software, it's not magically going to become open source. The way it becomes open source is the developer actively chooses to license it in an open source way, whether that be under a MIT license, one of the BSD variants, an Apache license, so on and so forth. There is a lot of open source licenses to choose from, but those are some of the more common ones. Open source is not the only way that a project can be open source in the non-technical usage of the term. We also have source available, where you can look at the code, you can read the code, you can examine the code, maybe you can even take parts of the code and use it in other projects under specific situations. But the difference with source available is there are often really heavy restrictions on what can be done with the code, whether the code can be redistributed in its current form. Sometimes you can look at the code and you can build stuff off of the code, but you can't take that code base and redistribute it as is. Sometimes you can look at the code, but you can't fork the project and build something off of it. Which is also different from leaked source code. We have a proprietary project that never intended to release the source code. But whether it's through bad data practices, an external data leak, a bad actor, the source code becomes publicly available. For example, Windows XP. Which is also different from a decompilation effort, where the aim is to reverse the compilation process and recreate the source code, like the OpenGL project for the Jak and Daxter games. All of these are very, very different things, and if you're in the FOSS world, you understand the difference between open source, source available, leaked source code, and decompilation. But how many times have you seen people that don't understand the difference call all of these things open source? Now, this is point number one of our mental gymnastics, and we'll come back to this a little bit later. Let's talk about point number two, the assembly part. Because if we say everything is open source if we know assembly, this gets into the issue of what do we mean by the source part? What do we mean by source code? One definition is a text listing of commands to be compiled or assembled into an executable computer program. So if you write a program in Python, this is a text listing of Python commands, which are not compiled. In this case, they are interpreted into an executable computer program. The same is true for C, for Rust, for Ruby, Perl, any other language out there. Now, this is when you're dealing with high-level languages. I'm including C in the concept of high-level languages here. It's not a language the computer directly understands. But there are other ways we can define this. A plain text computer program written in a programming language. Now, you don't have to write a program in a language that is abstracted from what the computer understands. You don't have to write C. You don't have to write Python. You can write a program directly in assembly. And whilst it's not that common for regular applications today, it was in the past, and it still has a place for specialized applications, especially in embedded systems. So if a program is written in C, you would usually say the source code for that project is in C. But if the project is written in assembly, there's no argument to be made that any other language is the source code language. In that context, assembly is the source code. Okay, I hope with everything I've said so far, you can agree. Sometimes people that are not in the FOSS world use the term open source incorrectly to refer to all of these other things which kinda look open source, but have their very clear distinctions. There are cases where a project is written in assembly, and that means the assembly is the source code in that case. And a way you can define source code is a plain text computer program written in a programming language. It might not be the most complete definition, but it's certainly a simplified high-level definition. Now, some of you can probably see where I'm going here, but let's start the mental gymnastics and overthink how this joke can be true. Okay, if instead of using the technical definition of open source, where open source is defined by the open source definition and has all of these other requirements about specifically what the term open source means, we instead use the more non-technical use case where open source, source available, leaked source code, decompilation, well, you can see the code that runs the application in all of these, so they're all basically open source anyway. The source code's there, the code is there. I don't know the difference between source code and code anyway, so it does the thing, it seems good enough. And we also acknowledge that assembly is a programming language. You can write a program in assembly. And also, source code is just a plain text computer program written in a programming language. You can see the assembly for any program out there. Like, that's a really easy thing to do. So, by this very broken logic of intentionally using terms wrong and using very loose definitions in a really stupid way, we could technically say all software is open source if you know assembly. Now, under any level of scrutiny and thinking about this for more than 3 seconds and having any sort of technical FOSS background, you're going to realize that's a really stupid thing to say, and this is why it's a joke. But jokes are generally funny when there is some level of truth to them. On a side note, much like the term free software, I really don't like the term open source, because open source, whilst nowadays being used technically with the open source definition, that's not the only definition it's had, and it did see use before the OSI. So much like the term free software, meaning both Libre software, freedom software, it also means monetarily free software. And if you have to explain what a word means with a sentence because you're overlapping with two other definitions, I think you might need a better term to make sure that doesn't happen. And open source, I understand why it gets misused, because firstly, people misuse it. So you see other people misusing it, so you're going to misuse it yourself. But when you think of the term open, you think visible, you think viewable, and all of these other things where the source code is available to see, it's open to see. I get why people call these things open source, and I wish there was a better term that we could use. So, what do you think? Is all software open source if you know assembly? Or have the mental gymnastics not convinced you and you're still going to say it's a stupid statement? I would love to know. And if you already thought that it was true anyway without the mental gymnastics, I would like to know in the comment section down below why. Please do that. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, LiberaPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And I honestly don't know why I made this video. I genuinely don't know why it happened.